boiling point of a liquid, if vapor pressure is the pressure exerted by the vapor molecules, pressure exerted by the vapor in equilibrium state, in equilibrium conditions, an equilibrium state at constant temperature, at a given temperature T, is known as vapor pressure. If I am taking the pressure exerted at equilibrium state or in equilibrium state, what is the equilibrium? Liquid and vapor are in equilibrium, so you know the pressure exerted will be vapor pressure. But now what happens, what are the factors on which this vapor pressure depends on? This depends on only two factors. One is temperature, the second one is nature of the liquid. Temperature and nature of liquid. When I say nature of the liquid, we know more volatile the nature of a liquid, more is the vapor molecules that will be present above the surface of the liquid, more will be the pressure exerted by the vapor molecule. So vapor molecules number increases, vapor pressure increases. So vapor pressure directly proportional to volatile nature. But here another point is also there, the temperature. Equilibrium state can be affected only by temperature. So the equilibrium can be affected only by temperature. So vapor pressure is directly proportional to temperature. But what is the dependence of this vapor pressure is, it is exponentially dependent on temperature. Exponentially dependent on temperature. It is exponentially dependent on temperature, means to say, when I say a graphical representation of vapor pressure versus temperature, it will increase with increase in the temperature, but the increase is not in a linear way, it is exponential. It is exponentially dependent on the temperature, such that there will be a state that will be achieved. If I take at one particular point, let us imagine you have a 0 mm pressure, from started with 0 mm of pressure, you have reached to 100 mm, 200 mm. If I say this is 300 mm, some 400 mm or 500, slowly you came to 700 mm and now you came to 760 mm. I have reached to 760 mm. What is this meaning of 760 mm? We know 760 mm is equals to 1 atmosphere, is equals to 1 atmosphere. If this is taken as external pressure in the atmosphere, external pressure or atmospheric pressure, this is taken as external pressure or atmospheric pressure, at atmospheric pressure condition, that means the outside temperature and pressure are maintained constant, the external pressure is taken as atmospheric pressure above the sea level, which is always equals to 1 atmosphere. 1 atmosphere is nothing but 760 mm. So the vapor pressure every time is increasing with increase in temperature, increasing with increase in temperature, there will be a state that will be reached when this vapor pressure will go and reach this particular point. At this point, you will see the vapor pressure of a liquid will be equals to the atmospheric pressure. Vapor pressure becomes equals to atmospheric pressure. At this point, what happens at this point, if I say, if you drop this particular onto the temperature, this particular temperature is known as, the temperature which is taken here is known as boiling point. What happens to the liquid? Now the liquid, entire liquid is now behaving like a gas. Entire liquid is now behaving like a state where it is ready to convert into gas. We can say in such a way it is not completely gas, but the entire bulk of the liquid is now free to move and free to escape into the atmosphere, because the temperature you have provided every time is sufficiently enough to break attractive forces between each and every molecule. And every time the energy of this thermal energy is being utilized to raise their kinetic energy, maximum number of molecules. Remember in the previous, if I say in the evaporation, it is only on the surface the molecules are ready to escape. But here maximum number of molecules in the bulk are in the high energy range and very few will be left out in the low energy range. So that means here how much ever they exchange their energy, still the molecules are sufficiently enough to escape into the vapor state from any layer of the liquid. And that is what we say, the boiling process is a bulk phenomena, and the boiling point can be defined as the temperature at which the vapor pressure of the liquid becomes equals to external pressure is known as boiling point. If the vapor pressure is equals to external pressure, this point, the temperature corresponding to that point is taken as boiling point.